Title of the post, Eternal Wait. A nearly deserted lane, a barber shop in the shanty of that lane. Young barber is on the edge of his shop. He reads a newspaper. We don't know if he's reading. We also don't know if the paper is recent or even upside down. Like a hawk, his eyes dart left to right, then right to left swiftly, and then rest back on the newspaper. He is not reading the paper. He can't be. He is merely there, on the edge of his shop, on the edge of his life, on the edge. He is waiting. Waiting for an elusive customer to come in and stare at the mirror casually, move his fingers through his thick growth and ask for a haircut or a shave at least. Barber does not budge. He is like a tiger in the wild. He has to shave someone, shave off a few rupees from someone. He lowers the newspaper a bit to search for someone scratching his beard or a hero looking boy with long hair. Soon he has to spot such a kill who might occupy his empty chair. And he knows it best, waiting is not easy. He wipes the mirror, dusts the chair, then goes back to the hunting point. He is tense. His body is getting tight. Worst of all, he is helpless. At the back of the shop hangs a brown, grimy gunny bag curtain. On the other side of the gunny bag curtain, a female skeleton is leaning on a frail wall. A girl is scribbling on a notebook. Her school fees has to be paid. A baby is squirming in skeleton's lap. He cries, suckling the hanging breast. Utensils are empty. Stuff is cold. Life is on hold. On both sides of the brown, grimy, sad, gunny bag curtain. Thank you.